Today, I will be comparing two classic musicals with a film focused on societal expectations. The two films that I chose are Hairspray and Grease. The main topic will be the expectations that women have in today's society to require them to be a certain way. They must look a specific manner and have a long list of things that they can and can't do to fit into society's definition of a woman. Hairspray is a 2007 film set in the 60s to speak on the issue of racism, in specifics, the civil rights movement of the 1960s. The main character, Tracy, a heavy Caucasian high school girl, advocates for black recognition on a public TV show. Throughout the musical, we see her befriend plenty of colored people and even participates in a protest fighting for the black community's screen time. She continues to pursue her dream to dance on the show with her newfound friends and rallies against racial segregation. The 1978 classic, Grease, experiences the fellowships, settlements, and undertakings of a gathering of high school kids during the 1950s. Sandy, the main character, faces many internal dilemmas when it comes to things that everyone began to expect from her. As a virgin who was waiting until marriage, she was looked down upon by her friends for not doing the things the rest of them were. She goes through a series of changes to please the people around her, but at the end of the day, she prefers herself in her body with her own set of rules. Women have plenty of expectations and requirements that they need to have in order for society to classify them as a woman or as feminine. This also comes in play whenever we see women being body shamed or degraded for not participating in sexual activities before a certain age. In this clip from Hairspray, we see Tracy and a few other girls trying out to be on the famous Courtney Collins show. Velma Montussel, the show's manager, and her daughter Amber immediately begin to say rude things about a participant's looks. They criticized the size of her nose and the clothes that she was wearing and told her that looking that way, no man will ever want to be with her.
This one will never get a date in those hand-me-down clothes.
Ah, kid, she'll never get a date until Daddy buys her new nose. I would say, Oiga Bolt, if I wasn't Miss Baltimore Grass.
A few moments later, we see them turn their attention towards our main character, Tracy. They begin to body shame her and force the idea on her that with the figure that she had, she would never make it far in life, therefore leading them to simply kicking her out.
And may I be frank? First impressions can be tough, and when I saw you, I knew it. If your size weren't enough, your last answer just blew it. And so, my dear, so short and stout, you'll never be in,
so we're kicking you out.
With your form and your face, oh, well, it isn't your fault. You're just down with a case of Miss
In Grease, we have a set of friends having a sleepover, which Sandy, our main character, was invited to. She attended the sleepover with the girls, and while Sandy was in the bathroom, one of them proceeds to put on a wig and impersonate Sandy and make fun of her for being a virgin and waiting until marriage.
Look at me, I'm Sandra D. Lousy with virginity. Won't go to bed till I'm legally wed. I can't, I'm Sandra D. Watch it.
Hey, I'm Doris Day.
In both films, we see that body image and body positivity is immediately a very prominent topic. In Hairspray, Tracy is already an outsider because she's a heavier weight than the rest of the girls on the show. They treat her differently, and they don't even give her a chance at friendship because automatically her weight determines where in the popularity hierarchy she stands. It's no longer about talent or determination. It's simply about the first impression, what everyone first notices. Here, it's Tracy's weight. Throughout the musical, we do see an emphasis on Tracy's weight. During some songs, she even refers to herself as heavyweight champion. In Greece, the societal expectation that we are analyzing is the requirement for girls to be having sex at a young age. It is important to note that not everyone has the same views on things like involving in sexual activities while still in school. Many of these opinions depend on factors such as religion, family, just any cultural background can change the way that people view this topic. Putting ourselves in their shoes, since the film is based on a 50s setting, we see how girls might have felt more pressured to simply fit into the regulations rather than to rebel from them and try to make change. Everyone just wanted to be accepted and have friends. This is the justification for the way that they reacted to these situations. Another thing women get a lot of unnecessary commentary about is the way that they dress and perceive themselves. The way that they act can also determine if they are feminine or not. Although completely untrue, in today's society, you have to fit into regulations to be accepted.
To announce that Amber Von Tussle
is about to get out dance.
Tracy Turnblad!
When Tracy is first introduced to the show, she has a different appearance and people react to her completely differently than when she appeared on the show in the last scene. Here, her hair is different and she's wearing a shorter dress. The audience automatically perceives her in a different way for simply changing her appearance. These are things that we see in today's society as well. It is not rare that we change the way we view others based on their looks or their actions.
The best that I can today, 'cause you can't stop the motion of the ocean on the side of-
Sandy?
Tell me about it, Stern.
At first, no one really took Sandy seriously because she dressed in a very innocent manner. She always covered up and wore light colors. One day, she shows up in edgier, tighter clothing, and suddenly everyone turned and saw her with different eyes. They saw what men expect to see when they think of a beautiful woman. In Hairspray, we see how Tracy reappears on the show with a completely new look. Although she didn't give in to what people said about her weight and changed that about herself, it's significantly important to acknowledge the need for her character to have a change in her appearance. The director needed the audience, both in the musical and outside of it, to see her again as if it were the first time. All weight expectations removed and simply focusing on her personality through the film as our background, we see her as the hero of this story. Even her enemy's love interest leaves her for Tracy because they saw beyond the societal expectations and chose her personality. In Greece, it's more clear how Sandy took what everyone was saying about her into consideration and changed the way she looked. A very important factor here is the time difference between the two films. The first film is set in the 60s, while Greece was set in the 50s. Although 10 years might not seem like a long time gap, the changes are still there. Hairspray has a more racial aspect to it, while Grease is mainly focusing on only body positivity. Both, though, have the same topic and focus.